Hello! For today, I have a special surprise. I've got a real fan letter with a question for me, so I have been told. So I thought I will make a tutorial out of answering the question. And here we go. Let's read it together. I wonder what the question will be. Dear Dr. Wisenhimer, I'm Professor Johnson from Harvard University. A fellow colleague. By coincidence, I came across your tutorial. While watching it, one question came to my mind. Please be so kind to satisfy my curiosity. It will be my honor to help my fellow scientist from Harvard. Really, that's an honor for me. And is your doctor title from a real university? And if so, how much did you pay for it? Very interesting question. I think what Professor Johnson is really wants to ask is, what is a Mandelbox? Maybe Professor Johnson watched the last history issue where this amazing object was introduced. Its main idea bases on a folding operation, like I do here with this paper. When we fold it once and cut something out, and fold it twice and cut some more out. And look what we have done here. We see that operations on a folded piece of paper happens on each layer of the fold at the same time. The folding operation is essential for the Mandelbox. Now let's take a look at the exact mathematical definition and examine the formula.
Like the Mandelbrot set, a Mandelbox is calculated by applying a formula repeatedly to every point in space. A point is part of a Mandelbox if it does not escape to infinity. It replaces the Mandelbrot equation z equals z squared plus z with this formula. The discoverer Tom Lowell explains the idea behind the formula. According to Louis Weyl's theorem from 1850, shape-preserving operations are rotations, translations, scale, reflections, and inversions. The formula unites all those possible transformations elegantly. Like the Mandelbrot formula, it consists of rotation, scaling, and translation, but it also includes the inversion and reflection as additional operations. Now we are going to look at each part of the formula before we examine their behavior in a combined method. The box fold operation folds the space at a folding break around an axis. First a folding at the x-axis is performed, followed by the folding of the y-axis. The sphere fold is applying an inversion to all points within a certain radius. The scaling contains rotation as well. Here we see a scaling of negative 2 and a rotation by 180 degrees. The last transformation is the translation.
Now we have seen the transformations that make up the Mandelbox. All of those transformations are easily convertible to 3D. But for visualizing the iteration process, we continue using the 2D variants of it. I keep unfolding the letter, and you examine the standard Mandelbox iteration with its default parameters.
This is what the default Mandelbox looks like in 3D. This is a two-dimensional slice of the Mandelbox XY plane. Watch the iteration process.
In the beginning, we see nothing because everything is acting on a zero parameter value. We have to wait for the addition operation to bring every point in its initial starting position. The circle that you are seeing right there is the bailout radius. Every pixel that lies outside this radius is considered never coming back to the zero area. If it happens, it is moved back to its starting location and is colored throughout the color palette according to the iteration when it has left the bailout radius. Right now, we don't have any point leaving the bailout radius. But this is going to happen soon. And here we have now the first points that are moving to the starting position because they have bailout and they start forming the image.
We fast forward to the end of the iteration process, watching the second last iteration perform, finalizing the image. The whole process with 15 iterations is available with Dr. Wisenhimer's comments in the spin-off parts of this issue.
Now, we have reached the last iteration. The points that are now left inside the bailout radius are just moved back to their starting locations and given the color black. That was impressive, seeing the transformations in action. Let me show you the special corner of the negative 1.5 Mandelbox, as has been introduced in the show of the Keeper of the Chaos. This area of the Mandelbox is crowded with Apollonian gaskets. Let us now examine what leads to these structures by visualizing the iteration process of a centered Apollonian gasket. Remember that bringing up a negative scaling value now introduces a rotation by 180 degrees, performing a scaling of just 50%.
This is a flyby of the Apollonian corner of the 3D Mandelbox. Watch what is happening in the corner of the Mandelbox with a negative scale of 1.5.
We now want to look at the iteration process of the Apollonian corner from the Mandelbox negative 1.5 scale. And as a starter, we zoom into the location where we want to examine the iteration behavior from. And then we lower the resolution to track the points throughout the iteration process. Again, on the start of the iteration process, we start with a zero value, meaning that the first operations cannot act on anything. What is now interesting is that the addition operation moves the points towards the starting area, which we have zoomed right before. And it is now taking a few more iterations before the first points bail out. The circle that you are seeing right there is the bailout radius. Every pixel that lies outside this radius is considered never coming back to the zero area. If it happens, it is moved back to its starting location and is colored throughout the color palette according to the iteration when it has left the bailout radius. Right now, we don't have any point leaving the bailout radius, but this is going to happen soon. Here we have now the first points that are moving to the starting position because they have bailouted and they start forming the image.
We fast forward to the end of the iteration process, watching the second last iteration perform, finalizing the image. The whole process with 15 iterations is available with Dr. Wisenhimer comments in the spin-off parts of this issue.
And finally we have reached the last iteration and the remaining points are now shifted back to the starting locations. And isn't that interesting that they have been starting right from the circles that form the Apollonian square? And through the zooming process, an interesting subshape has become visible. And now we are finished with this part of the Mandelbox. I hope You enjoyed it very much. See you next time. I hope you gained some knowledge from this presentation. I have prepared a visualization of the negative 2 Mandelbox as well. And this brings us to the end of the show. Send in your questions, and I'm glad to answer them personally. So, send your questions on paper. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.